Have you decided to implement Google's new consent mode version 2, but you don't know where to start? I can help with that. Subscribe and check out my previous videos covering what you need to get started, and then you're ready to begin implementation. Before activating consent mode version 2, you will want to implement a default status for consents. Consider this your backup plan if no consent is given yet. This is especially necessary when you want to implement the advanced mode. First step is to set a default status for all the consents. This default status is set via a script that needs to be added to the website. It's important to note that the script needs to be loaded before the CMP, the Google Tag Manager, and any other tracking scripts from Google. The script looks like this. The first line initializes the data layer with a communication variable that is used for communication between website, CMP, and Tag Manager. Lines 2 to 4 initialize the so-called GTAG function. This is used by the Google tools to send data into the data layer. Lines 5 to 11 set default states for the consent mode parameters. Depending on your local regulations, these parameters should always set to denied. The wait for update parameter ensures that the CMP's consent mode signals are processed by the tag management system. Line 12 contains the adds data redaction parameter. Set this to true to remove add-click identifiers from network requests for users that have not given consent. Line 13 contains the URL pass-through parameter. Set this to true to enable the pass-through of add-click parameters through a session. If activated, Google will automatically add add-click parameters to every link on your website to make sure that a conversion is reported from the correct add-click. A warning though, this can cause malfunctions on your website, especially on internal site searches. Please do a proper test of your full website after activating that feature. For Cookiebot CMP, it's also important to add this parameter to the script tag. If you have implemented your CMP through Google Tag Manager, you can also set these default values via your Cookiebot or Usercentrics tags. Just set the default state for each parameter as needed. You can also apply a different default status for users from a specific geographical region by specifying the region code together with the default status. If you do this implementation through Google Tag Manager, you don't need to add the code block from the beginning of this video. For more on Google Consent Mode version 2, sign up to our free course in the link below. You will learn how to implement it and what happens if you don't, whether you need the basic or the advanced mode, what the digital future holds for digital advertising and marketing in this new legal and technical landscape. This course is brought to you by Usercentrics and Cookiebot in collaboration with DWC.